गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल. टुडे वी विल गोइंग टू डिस्कस आर नेक्स्ट टाइप ऑफ केमिकल रिएक्शन, दैट इज ऑक्सीडेशन रिएक्शन. एज यू ऑल नो, ऑन ऑक्सीडेशन एल्डिहाइड्स एंड कीटोन्स विल गोइंग टू गिव अस कार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड. द ऑक्सीडाइजिंग एजेंट विच वी आर गोइंग टू यूज इन दिस, दे विल बी KMnO4 एंड K2Cr2O7. So let's take aldehyde, and on oxidation it will going to give us carboxylic acid. Similarly, if we will take ketone, then on oxidation it will going to give us RCOOH plus R-OOH, that is carboxylic acid. For example, if we have CH3CHO, then on oxidation it will going to give us CH3COOH, that is ethanoic acid. Now if we have acetone, then on oxidation it will going to give us CH3COOH plus HCOOH, means in this we will going to get two products. In this, or you can say in ketones, the formation of product will take place according to Popov rules. According to this rule, the carboxylic acid group is formed in such a manner that the keto group stays with the smaller alkyl group. For example, if we have CH3, CH2, CH2, C double bond O, CH3. Then in this, if the cleavage is taking from here on oxidation, then the product is CH3, CH2, CH2, COOH. And the second product will be HCOOH. Now, if the cleavage is taking from here, then the product will be CH3, CH2, COOH plus CH3, COOH. In this will be the minor product and this will be the major product. Why? Because according to Popov rule, the keto group will going to stay with the smaller alkyl group. Now, if we are going to do the oxidation with mild oxidizing agent in place of strong oxidizing agent, then they will going to oxidize only aldehydes, not ketones. With this, we can also distinguish between aldehydes and ketones. So, the first mild oxidizing agent is Tollens reagent. First is Tollens reagent. Tollens reagent is also known as silver mirror test. And it is only shown by aldehyde. Now, what is Tollens reagent? Tollens reagent is the ammonical solution. Is the ammonical solution of AgNO3. Now, let's do the reaction. Take an aldehyde and react this with the Tollens reagent, that is ammonical solution of silver nitrate, that will be AgNH3 twice. And this reaction will going to take place in the alkaline medium. So it will going to give us RCOO negative plus Ag plus H2O plus NH3. And this silver will going to give us the lining of silver mirror. Silver mirror. Let's balance this reaction. Let's put here 2, 3, then here will also be 2, 2 and here will be 4. So this is the reaction for the Tollens reagent. The another test which is given by aldehyde, that is Fehling solution test. Fehling solution test. Fehling solution is having a two types of solution. First is Fehling solution A and second is Fehling solution B. Fehling solution A is having a aqueous solution of copper sulfate, whereas Fehling solution B is having a alkaline solution of sodium potassium tartrate. This is also known as Rochelle salt. In this, we will take aldehyde and we will going to react it with the equimolar solution of A and B. So let's do the reaction. Take aldehyde and do the reaction with Cu2 positive plus OH negative. Then it will going to give us acid plus Cu2O, which will going to give us the reddish brown precipitate. Plus it will going to give us water molecule. Now let's balance this reaction. Let's write here 2, 5. And here 3. Like aldehyde, ketone also show a test which is known as haloform test. But this test is only shown by those ketones which have a methyl group. Let's take an example. CH3, CH2, C double bond O CH3. As you can see in this ketone, the methyl group is present on one side. So this compound can show the haloform test. Whereas if we have CH2, CH3, CH2, C double bond O, CH2, CH3. If I have a compound like this, then this side also ethyl, this side also ethyl group is present. So in this, we don't have methyl group. So this will not going to show us the haloform test. So let's take an example. If we have CH3, C double bond O CH3, that is acetone, and we are reacting it with 3 molecules of I2, then it will going to give us CH3, C double bond O. These 3 hydrogen will get substituted and it will give Ci3 plus 3Hi will be out. Now when we will react CH3, C double bond O, Ci3 with NaOH, then it will going to give us iodoform, a yellow color precipitate. Of iodoform plus what is left here, that is CH3. C double bond O, O N A. Now, in aldehyde, only acetaldehyde will going to show us this test. Why only acetaldehyde? Because in acetaldehyde, the methyl group is present. React it with 3I2. It will going to substitute all the 3 hydrogen. Ci3 plus C double bond O H plus it will going to give Hi. Now when we will going to react this with NaOH, it will going to give us CHI3, that is halofoam, plus what is left, that is HCOONA. So with this we are completing our third type of chemical reaction, that is oxidation reaction. Now let's come to our fourth type of reaction, that is reduction reaction. On reduction, aldehydes and ketones will going to give us alcohols. Aldehyde will give primary alcohol, whereas ketones will going to give us secondary alcohol. The reducing agent which we can use in this, that is lithium aluminium hydride and sodium borohydride and platinum, palladium and nickel. Now in this, take aldehyde, do the reduction in the presence of lithium aluminium hydride, then it will going to give us alcohol, CH2OH. Now if we have ketone, CH3, C double bond O, CH3, and we are doing reduction in the presence of lithium aluminium hydride, 1H will go to carbon and 1H will go to oxygen, so it will be CH3CHOH CH3. Now similarly, if we have benzaldehyde and we are doing reduction in the presence, so in the presence of platinum, then it will going to give us benzyl alcohol. So this was the reduction to alcohol. Now on reduction, aldehydes and ketones can give hydrocarbons. Reduction to hydrocarbon. Now in this case, the first reaction is Kelvinson reduction. In Kelvinson reduction, take aldehyde and react it with the 4-nascent hydrogen in the presence of zinc mercury amalgam and HCl. Now this will going to give us CH3CH3 plus H2O will going to come out. Now if we have acetone and we are doing reduction in the presence of nascent hydrogen and zinc mercury amalgam and HCl, then it will going to give us CH3CH2CH3 plus H2O. Similarly, if we have acetophenone and we are doing reduction with the nascent hydrogen in the presence of zinc mercury amalgam and HCl, then it will going to give us CH2CH3 plus H2O will come out, that is phenyl ethane. Second reaction is Wolff-Kishner reaction. Wolff-Kishner reduction reaction. In this also, aldehyde and ketone will going to convert into an hydrocarbon. So in this, take aldehyde and react it with hydrazine. H2O will going to come out and it will going to give us RCH double bond NH2. Then if we are reacting this with KOH in the presence of glycol, then it will going to give us R CH3 plus N2. Now let's do our next reaction, that is reduction with HI and red phosphorus. In this, take aldehyde and react it with the four molecules of HI. In the presence of red phosphorus, it will going to give us RCH3 plus H2O plus 2I2. Similarly, if we have ketone and we are reacting it with 4HI, in the presence of red phosphorus, again it will going to give us alkane plus water plus 2I2. In this, our last reaction is, that is reduction to pinacol. Reduction to pinacols. In this, we need to take two molecules of ketone, CH3 double bond OCH3 plus CH3C double bond OCH3, and react it with two nascent hydrogen. In the presence of mercury, magnesium mercury, it will going to give us CH3COH, CH3COH, CH3CH3. This is known as pinacol. This reaction is only given by ketones. So with this, we are completing our fourth type of reaction, that is reduction reaction. So I hope you have understood today's topic. That's all for today. Have a nice day ahead.